everyone, it's Jen and Belle, and we are here today in our new location to do a short video on reading styles. I saw that Misty the Book Rat, or the Book Rat Misty as she's known here on YouTube, did one of these during the week, so I thought that since I didn't have a book haul for you guys this week, I would do this. So there's no really specific questions, but I'm kind of just going to go off the questions that she answered or came up with herself. So let's get started. So the first one is, where do you like to read? Okay, well, I like to read, I have to read in a place that's comfy. If I'm uncomfortable, I'll do nothing. Belle, you can't lean on there. Sorry about that. I'll do nothing but fidget around. So, I used to like to go to Barnes & Noble and get myself like a pumpkin spice latte and sit in their big comfy chairs and read. But Barnes & Noble took away those big comfy chairs. So, no more reading in the big comfy chairs. So, what I would try to do then was, I always bring my own book with me. I don't take their books off the shelf, because if I get a book that somebody's already read and I'm paying for it for a brand new book, I don't like that. That makes me upset. So I bring my own book so I don't ruin any books for anybody else. But anyway, so I used to bring my book with me and I would just sit on the floor, because once they took away the comfy chairs, there was a lot of room and lots of people sit on the floor. But I don't think I ever mentioned this, but I have fibromyalgia. And what that is a pain syndrome where I'm in pain like 99% of the day, or 99% of my life. I'm always in pain. It hurts to have somebody hug me, or for the dogs to stand on me, or to sit on hard surfaces. So I really couldn't sit on the floor of Barnes & Noble anymore, so I had to give that up. So now when I go to the Barnes & Noble, I just really just walk around. I really can't sit on the floor because it's kind of like shooting, stabbing, extremely bad pain in my legs, in my back, in my butt. So it's not worth it. So now what I like to read is, I like to read in bed, but I usually fall asleep, so I can't do that. I can't do it for too long. I like to read on my couch. We have, you've seen my couches in my videos. They're big and fluffy and comfy, and yeah, I love those. So I usually sit in front of the big windows and read there. Or where else do I like to read? Oh, I love to read on my porch. That's my all-time favorite thing. I love taking Belle out there. She has a dog stroller, and we go sit out there together. She's very good. She doesn't try to run away, and we just veg out on the porch, and I love being in the fresh air. I didn't get to do that a lot this summer because it was extremely hot, so yeah, I didn't get to do that too much this year, but now that it's getting cooler, I can snuggle up with a fleece blanket, which is one thing I have to have, my fleece blanket, and maybe some coffee, and just go sit outside and be in the fresh air, and I really like that. So that's where I like to read. I don't like to read in the tub. Actually, I never take baths because I feel like I'm sitting in my own filth, even though I know everyone says, oh, you can take your shower. Yeah, no, I can't take a bath. It's one of those quirky things about me, that things that just gross me out or whatever, can't do it. So I don't like reading the pool or bath or anything like that, and I obviously can't read in the shower. So, yeah. So sitting on the porch would probably be my favorite place, as long as the weather permits. All right. Moving on to what do you drink while you're reading? Well, that really wasn't one of the questions, but I added in there anyway. It depends. I mostly drink tea when I'm reading. Depends on the time of day. If it's early in the morning, I'll drink coffee, or if I'm at Barnes & Noble, I'll drink coffee, especially if they have the pumpkin spice latte. Yes, this we like. Or if they have one of the holiday ones, like the gingerbread or something like that. I like those. That's pretty much it. Or water. I drink a lot of bottled water. So that's pretty much what I like. But I really like to cuddle up with a hot cup of tea and just hold it and, you know, read and turn the pages and get lost. That's fun. Paperback or hardcover? Both. I used to only want hardcovers. But I find that like a lot of the young adult books, are so much easier to hold in a paperback. Some people don't like the mass market paperbacks like these. Yes, because they're small and they can be difficult to hold, but I don't mind. I like, really, you know what, if I'm going to get a book, that makes my day. So does it matter if it's hardcover or paperback or, no, it really doesn't. The only thing is, I do want my books to match. So, like, I have, where are they? I have these two. Perfect Chemistry and Rules of Attraction, which are in paperback. And then I have the, oh, Belle's trying to leave. I have the other one, Chain Reaction, up there, and it's hardcover. So when the paperback comes out, I'm going to have to get the paperback so they all match. But that's, like, the only thing that really is, like, a quirk for me. Other than that, paperback, hardcover, it's all the same to me. Do I reread books? No. I don't like to reread books. I have no time to reread books. The only book I would maybe reread is The 13th Tale, because that's my all-time favorite book. Even, like, Twilight, Harry Potter, I love those books, but I don't have time to reread them. I have all these books to read, so there's no time for that. I want to move on to the next story, and that's okay. I know some people like to reread books, and there's nothing wrong with that. It's just that I don't have the time for that, so no, I don't do that. And then the last question is, do you have any quirky reading habits? I'm sure that I do. One of them is my bookmark. The bookmark is like the bane of my existence. No, I love bookmarks. I have a ton of them. But the thing about it is, when I put my bookmark down, I'm constantly wondering where my bookmark is. I always, like, I'm feeling around, where is my bookmark? Did it get lost? Did it fall on the couch? Did it fall on the floor? And this is going through my head while I'm trying to read the book. So it's not working out for me here. I've tried to put the bookmark in, like, in a back page or past a point I've already read. It also does not work because it, like, puts a crease in the page or a bump in the page. I don't like that either. So no choice. And I don't like to take the cover, like if it has a French flap like this, I don't like to take that and put it in there like that because it freaks me out. I don't like the way this looks. It's just not normal. I'm not normal. That's what the problem is. So, yeah. I can't get you back in there. So, that's one quirk that I have. So, I'm never going to get around this unless I just train myself to not worry about what my bookmark is. But, okay. Any other quirks that I have with reading? I tend to really, really want a book, and then I get it, and then, like, the anticipation dies down, and then I'm onto something else. And then I end up reading something that I didn't think I was going to read because I wanted to read the thing I was really excited about, and that always happens to me. I'm sure that happens to a lot of people, but that's another quirk I have. I need to get something, I get it, and then I don't read it. I read something else, but I was, like, on a mission to get this book. So, I think that's all the quirks that I have with reading. I do go through phases with reading. Like, if it's the holiday time, like I told you, I have my selection of October Halloween books, and then for Christmas I read mostly Christmas books during the Christmas season because that's what I like to do. And then in springtime, I like to read stories about, like, stuff going on in spring or something like that. I don't know. I like to read a lot of Debbie Macomber books during the springtime. I like her series about the, I can't remember the name of it right now, the Blossom Street series. Yes, like that. Yeah, so that's another quirk I guess I have. I have to read things according to season. I think I'm getting OCD in my old age. I don't know. Okay, well, that's it. That's all the questions that I have, and that's all the answers that I can come up with right now. So if you want to do this, you could make a video response and post it to my page, or post it to BookRatMisty's page, because she's the originator of this. And I'd love to hear your responses, or if you just want to leave a comment. So that's it. Thanks for joining, and happy reading.